How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and a warm welcome to the final model train review to come of August this year of 2024. And folks, I did say we would be doing a Bachmann model, and I chose to do this Class 47, of which is a Class 47-4 in the ROG livery. That is an abbreviation of Rail Operations Group. So, without further ado, let's roll up my sleeve so I don't knock things flying, as you know. I'm going through a bit of an ascension, but I'm not really going to be talking about that in this, because this is about model trains and stuff, and the following details are as shown on the end of the box. Okay, folks, if you want to make a note of this number, you may do so. The reference number is 35-412Z. So, this is a Rails exclusive produced model. I do believe it was released in 2022. I haven't a clue, but I got this one during their sales. And this one is a Class 47-4, numbered as 47812. Rail Operations Group. Produced exclusively for Rails of Sheffield. So folks, let's spin the turntable around, because on these Bachmann models, we do have a data panel of the history about the Class 47s. So, if you want to take a moment to pause the video and read this, you may do so. Excuse me. Not sure what's wrong with my voice today, but I'm not going to stop narrating, because I'm going to keep on going no matter what. That's just the way I am. So, let's get this out of the box then, folks. Okay. This is one of the newer Class 47s. As I was trying to say there, just thought I'd edit that bit of the video out. But anyways, this is one of the newer retooled Class 47s by Bachmann. And what we will do, just like I do with all the other reviews, let's cover the paperwork first then, folks. And this tells you how to operate and to look after your Class 47 and all that. Obviously, this one is a DCC ready version. There is no deluxe rotating fans or anything fancy on this one, but it is abundant with a ton of details. So there we go, folks. Just tells you many thanks for purchasing the model. Locomotive information, accessories, and interestingly, this one does come with a Plux 22 interface, so if you want to fit DCC, which we will come to in a moment, here is where to fit the accessory parts and all that, and we do have static display and all that good stuff, so if you want to fit the parts for display purposes only, that's grand, but not really recommended if you intend to run the model there, folks. But anyways, you've got three screws on the front and the back, making a total of six should you wish to remove the body shell for whatever reason, such as fitting a DCC decoder. Okay, as you know, this is the last one of August 2024, so I thought I'd end August on a good note, as that is one of my favorite months, and I really do like these Class 47 Greyhound locomotives. That's what I call them anyways. And we've got details of spare parts, warranty and stuff, and all that good stuff. Bachmann Collectors Club, warranty, service, repair form and all that good stuff. So there we go. That, my friends, is the paperwork and the packaging done. So we'll get this off and let's have a look at the model then. So, as you know, it's time to put the track on the turntable. Oh, so we'll have nowhere to stand our beautiful Class 47 on. I'm just going to bring this tray up to the camera for you. There is an abundant of parts in there for you to fit to the model as required. And these pliers are just simply connecting to the NEM coupling pockets and stuff. So, very much similar to what you get in the older model, but they have been enhanced, but we do have brand new tooling on this Class 47. And one thing I do advise folks, because there's a lot of detail on this one, please take care when removing this from the box, okay? What I'd recommend doing is just grabbing it from the body side and just stand it on the turntable like that. We're not going to break anything off because there is more detailed parts on this improved model from Bachmann. And I do have to say, Bachmann is possibly equivalent to the Mercedes Benz of 00 gauge model trains. So, here we go then, folks. I'm just going to grab this very carefully and I'm going to show you the roof, or at least try to, whilst getting a good grip on the model. We do have see-through grills on the roof fans there. These do not rotate on this version, but they do rotate on the deluxe siren fitted model. So we've got roof aerials, very nice detailing all round, very much self-explanatory. And I'm going to try and grab this and show you the underside of the model as well. So there we go, we've got all-wheel drive, no traction tires at all. And these Bachmann models, they are some of the best runners of any brand I've dealt with. Bachmann have never let me down in terms of their performance and stuff. They are fantastic models in my opinion, or at least these premium models are. And just look at that, folks. We've got the piping, cabling, we've got the battery boxes, two switches there, of which you will need something like a cocktail stick or something just to access these two wee switches here. And there's a fuel tank, more detail on the trucks. And that, my friends, is very much the introduction all done. So folks, the next part will be the close-ups and the full rotation. And I'll tell you this, I really am looking forward to doing a review of this one. And it will be the same test train as before, folks, because that's all I have to hand. And this is a solid runner. So I'll see you in the next one. Well, the next part. Okay, folks, now I've done the thumbnail, let's commence on with the close-ups. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to turn on my flashlight and try and show you the interior detail of the cab, if I can. And just trying to get the light in there without dazzling the interior. But as you can see there, folks, this newer Class 47 from Bachmann, it's really loaded with detail inside and out. There is no train crew on these newer Class 47s. And also another thing as well is that the cab windows, thankfully this time around, are in the closed position, as this stops dust and stuff getting inside the interior and potentially ruining it. But I would imagine that fitting a crew inside these locomotives should be fairly straightforward. And I do hope that showed some of the details and stuff. But as you know, another thing to point out as well, folks, is that these models do have cab lights, but they only work on DCC only. So, moving on to the close-ups, the rest of it. We do have sprung buffers, of which this one is sprung, but for some reason this one's decided to... There we go, that was just a wee bit stuck. We got that free, so it does happen. That's just transit for you, but this model is in perfect condition. It's not damaged or broken or anything like that, but the details, there is an abundance of separately fitted parts. The roof aerial, which I think is the NRN radio aerial. We do have the lamp holder just above the grab irons. These are all separately fitted parts. And there is an abundance of separately fitted detail parts in the bag, of which you can add further to the model if you want to enhance it even more. And this one does come with both NEM couplers fitted to the front and back. So, you can run this one just how you want to, really. And it is a cracking model overall. So, this one is numbered as 47812. Just check out the trucks here, folks. This is a lot better than the previous Bachmann model, and Bachmann has really put a lot of effort and a lot of dedication into this model. I mean, just look at all that beautiful piping that's been picked out in an off-white colour. We've got the brake shoes picked out in yellow. We've got the reddish coloured suspension springs, and just few minor details like that that really does enhance this model beyond the predecessor. We've got separately fitted handrails here, folks. Absolutely cracking. Full flush glazing all round. No corners cut here. It's an absolutely fantastic model all round. And just moving across the side of the locomotive here, folks. I do like this dark blue and what I'd call electric blue flashes all over the locomotive. I really like the graphics on this one. So, and then we've got the rail operations group picked out in silver. So, very nice model all round. And what I can say here, I would highly recommend it. Definitely a display model that's worth considering for the collector, but we will see how it runs during the performance test. So, there we go, folks. That is the close-ups all done. And do let me know what you think. Well, let me know your thoughts in terms of me using the flashlight to show the cab more. Would you like me to continue to do this in future reviews? Or would you like me to just roll back to just doing the normal angles? As you know, folks, I do these videos to help you guys to pick these model trains and stuff. And I do these out of my own money. I'm not sponsored or anything, but so I do appreciate all the feedback and stuff where I can improve my videos and what you would prefer to see from these unofficial model train reviews. Okay, folks, it's now time to move on to the full rotation. Right, folks, let's move on to the final part before we move on to the performance test, of which I'm sure all of you may well be looking forward to in terms of this Bachmann Class 47. So, without further ado, let's zoom out wide enough back and we'll do a full clockwise rotation. Just like so. And I will let the details and the livery very much speak for itself. It is a fantastic model from Bachmann, and the Bachmann branch line UK 00 gauge model trains are possibly some of the best ready to run model trains that you can buy on the market. However, they are not the cheapest, but they do cost the most. And this is why I do compare Bachmann to the Mercedes Benz of UK model trains and stuff, because they run great, they look great, and they are absolutely loaded with detail. And these models are prestige, and Bachmann UK have put a lot of work into these. So you do get a lot of detail for your money. But likewise, folks, I tend to wait for a sale, so if you do model on a budget, just keep an eye out for any special offers and stuff and take advantage of those, as that's what I did with this one. But anyway, folks, that concludes the close-ups. So let's get the test track all set up. Let's get this on the track with the test train and let's see what this can do during the performance test. Well, folks, it's now time for us to move on to the most fun part of all of my model train reviews that I always do. And I'm talking about the performance test. And as you can see there, folks, this is an absolute gorgeous model. In fact, if I can time this right with the throttle settings, and I just turn it enough just to turn on the lights and stuff, as you can see there, the lights do light up nicely on this one. But I will have to add more power, as I'm using analog to get the train moving. But as you can see there, folks, This is in default DC mode, and when I put more power on, the high intensity headlight turns on, and just look at that. We're only about just over 25% power there, folks. We're not even at 30% power. So we can go up to the safe margin of exactly 6 volts. And personally, it depends on the manufacturer, really. But this is exactly 6 volts. And personally, I'll just recommend giving it a run of about 30 to 45 minutes in each direction, just like this, just to allow the driveline and the gearing to bed in. So this is the first time it's been run. Some brands recommend running the locomotive without a load, other brands don't really care too much about it, as where others, you can just run them straight out of the box with a load of your choice and it will work. And I'm just referring to the case of the Dapol Class 59, and I did that one about 2 weeks ago, so feel free to check the playlist if you want to see that review for yourself. I was just rolling up the sleeves there, folks, because as you know, I don't like the sleeves to catch anything when I'm handling these model trains. So as you can see there, these Bachmann Class 47s, they are very nice models overall. And personally, I just want to say to Bachmann, and this is just from a neutral perspective, as I'm not biased towards any company or another, but I wholeheartedly do believe that Bachmann has done a grand job on these new retooled Class 47s. And if I'm not mistaken, I do believe that this one was released by Bachmann in 2022. So this is a Rouser Sheffield exclusive, so it's not in the catalogue, but I do believe it was released in 2022, if I'm not mistaken. But just look at it, folks. The detail. Thermal surface, planetary. And not only does this locomotive look nice, it runs fantastic as well. And by the way, folks, the first model train review to come of next month in September will be another Bachmann model train, because I really do like Bachmann, and it's one locomotive that I've never covered before in terms of doing a model train review. I've never done that one before at all, and that came today at the time I did, at the time I got this Class 47. That did come in the mail to me today as well, so that will be up next week to kickstart September. And as you know, folks, depending on how things go, there may or may not be some changes coming up for the channel, but it won't affect the Let's Play schedule. That will be unaffected. But in terms of old trains and stuff, as you know, I'm working on projects and stuff, so things may change. But as you know, in order to venture onto new things, we have to change and shake things up a bit, you know. But it will be worth it. And like I mentioned, I will continue to do more train content. But if I have to take a break after the next couple of reviews or something in order to get this project off the ground, then so be it. But in truth, I have done quite a lot of model train reviews over the years and stuff, and no, I'm not stopping the reviews. I will always continue to do them, but I do have other projects going on and other projects I want to tackle and take care of. And to be quite frankly honest, I'm going to probably take a break from doing model train reviews after the next 2 to 3, although I may take a break at the end of September, I don't know. But anyways, as you know me folks, things do change, and if I can continue to do these model train reviews and do the other project as well, so be it. But as you know folks, I just like to be honest with you all, because I do these videos from the free pendulums, as well as my content in general, of honesty, integrity, and morality. But just check that out folks, that class 47, it's just handling these tank cars as if they are nothing. There is quite a bit of weight behind this class 47, and this is being run straight from the box. I've not run it in or anything like that. I'm just running it as an excited buyer would buy their brand new model train, and they just want to get it on the track and get it run. As you know, I've only got this on just slightly under 6 volts. It's not quite 50% power, but it's not too far off. And it's just cruising along nicely. And these do use the Flux 22 pin DCC decoders. And I do like the brightness of the headlights, as well as the taillights, of which I will show in the second clip, just before we bring this review to a close. But as you can see there folks, you do get a lot of detail and stuff for your money. And I find these models, they can be obtained for a good price. I got this one for a good deal, and I would consider it excellent value for money. And at least one thing as well, one thing I do like the most about Bachmann, Akuriscal, and even Hornby, I find their model trains, they run generally okay. The same with Dapol, I find their trains run grand as well. I was just a wee bit disappointed with the Class 56 from Carblex models, but at the end of the day, I'm going to give them another try when they do another run of their Class 56s, because I think, to be honest, I may have just got a bad one. So I'm going to wait for another run with a different road number, as I will try and get another DC rail one, and as well a Colas version, but again different road numbers, as then they will be from the second batch run that I'm sure Cavlex models will do that. So I'm looking forward to that. But as you know folks, my model train review videos are done from a neutral perspective, and I don't have any favourites. I just say it the way it is, but I say it from experience, if anything, that Hornby, Bachmann, Dapol and Akuriscal have given me the least trouble in terms of running. And I just say it the way it is folks. Anyways, just going to allow a couple of more passes. I'm going to see how long I've been filming here. So, just checking that. We've just been filming for just over 10 minutes. So 2 more passes, just to allow for at least 10 minutes of constant running. As you know, I like to be thorough on these reviews. So 1 more pass after this, and then we'll know that we'll have our full 10 minutes of running before we switch the camera over to the second position, and this will show the tail lights in action as well. As you know, folks, I like to be honest with all of you, and that's what my reviews and content on this channel is all about. So this next pass, and then we will switch the camera, but I'll tell you something, I'm looking forward to my future. Well folks, this is just the second position here, just to show you the tail lights in action, and I'm sure most of you will agree with me that the tail lights are of the right ambience. Not too bright, not too dull, but just perfect for this latest reincarnation of the Bachmann post 2022 release of the Class 47 diesel locomotive of double O gauge. And I really do like the ROG livery on this one, I've got to be honest with you folks. And although we do gain a brand new abundance of separately fitted detail parts on these beautiful Class 47s, the downside is you no longer get a train crew in the cab, but I would imagine, and as long as you're careful, you could easily refit a driver or a train crew into the leading cab of your choice. And I like the fact that Bachmann has given you the flexibility of having a crew or not, as although the argument is it would look unrealistic running around with no train crew in the cab, but on the flip side of that, if you was just to have this sitting in a train yard or something doing nothing, it would just as look equally as unrealistic with a train crew inside the cab. So you've got the trade-off of, do you have a train crew or don't you have a train crew? So well done to Bachmann for giving us the flexibility to do this. And as you can see there folks, this train runs as smooth as butter. And I'll tell you this, I do compare Bachmann as the model train equivalent, especially these premium models in the UK model train market anyways. I'll class them as the model train version of Mercedes Benz. They have some of the best drive lines, handling, quality that you will get for your money. So that's just my experiences of these model trains. And just as a legal disclaimer as well folks, I am not connected to any model train company. I'm not financed by any model train company. I do these reviews out of my own money, and I aim to deliver these model train reviews out of the three principles of honesty, integrity and morality. And by the way, for just to remind you that the power setting I'm using here is 6 volts DC, just slightly under DC, 50% power. Anyways, just going to check to see how long I've been filming here. So, just coming up to about 3 minutes 45. So, a couple more passes or so, and then we can start moving on to winding down this review. And to be honest, this is the very first post 2022 Class 47 review that I've done. And to be honest, I'm very happy that I have invested into having the experience of what it's like to own, run and enjoy a 00 gauge Bachmann post 2022 passport and diesel. And I'll tell you something, this is one of the best Class 47 models I've ever owned. And second place, I'd say, for any Class 47 I've had from any brand would be Lima. But Bachmann is number one, Lima is number two. And they're some of the best models of the Class 47 you can buy for your money. But I didn't pay full price for this, I just held out for a sale and I got this one for a good deal. Of course, just to remind you, this is a Rouse of Sheffield commissioned model, so not many other retailers will sell this one, at least not brand new. Perhaps pre-owned ones maybe, but not brand new ones. And to be honest, I will always love the model train hobby. And I'm looking forward to doing many more reviews in the future as well. So folks, just to check to see how long we've been filming here. So we're well over the 5 minute mark in this place of the video. So that's had at least 15 minutes of total running. So what we'll do, we're just going to do one last pass and then we'll start winding it down, folks, okay? As then we've got at least 15 minutes of continuous footage. Okay folks, let's start winding down this review then. And the final one to come of August 2024. And I wanted to end this one on a good note. Details and features. An abundant, there's several separately fitted detail parts. And scrum buffers. Several light modes on DCC, although I'm using DC mode only, so they won't be covered in this review. This is the DCC ready version, so I'm going to give details and features a full house. 5 out of 5 there, folks. Performance. Very much self-explanatory. Silky smooth running all round. All-wheel drive. Very powerful. Coreless motor. A fairly heavy chassis. Exceptional running and handling. Straight from the box, no joltiness, no issues, so I'm going to give performance a full house, 5 out of 5 here folks. Quality, no issues on this model, nothing broken, nothing missing, just as expected, a very nice finesse model from Bachmann. Quality's all there. I'm going to give that a full house, 5 out of 5 as well, folks. However, I got this one for a deal, as if I paid full price for this, I would have not given it a full house 5, but because I got this one in a sale for a good deal, I'm going to give the price of this one also a full house, 5 out of 5 as well, folks. And that rounds this review off of this brand new post 2022 model of the Bachmann Class 47 diesel locomotive for the full house, 10 out of 10, as rightfully deserved. As always folks, just want to say thank you for watching. I do welcome your feedback, both positive and constructive. And until next time folks, take care of yourselves, take care of each other. All the best, God bless, take care, and I will see you in the next one. And next week's model train review will be another Bachmann model train. So stay tuned for that one. I'll see you later. We'll be right back.